Okay, folks, Mark Allen, BH Spring Solutions, LLC, bhspringsolutions.com, and we are about to take a look at the accuracy, function, and performance testing. And we're going to just review. This is testing of accuracy, function, and performance. Four different shooters. We already completed our shop review, which you see there. Kimber was fairly much the favorite out of the box in all the areas that we scored these pistols on, and you can see right there the items: concealability, grip hold, sureness of grip hold, comfort of grip hold, sight acquisition, weight, ease of manipulation of the mag release, capacity, and the overall quality of the finish of the pistol. And the scores came out here. The lower the score, the better your score in this particular case. We see here also that the Rock Islands all finish 1, 2, and 3, as in 4th, 5th, and 6th. And that is the 4 1/4 inch Commander, the 3 1/2 inch Rock Island Officers, and the Hunk of Rock, the 3.1 inch 10+1 round. So we'll see how those shop review scores work out when we start taking a look at the accuracy, function, and performance testing. The first accuracy, function, performance testing that was done by me, and that was at 18 yards. Again, the reason I chose this for my accuracy drill is because I would consider any of these handguns for my own personal use. Inside my home, the longest line of sight shot, that if there was a home invasion and I was able to take that 18 yard maximum line of sight shot, I'd like to be able to make a good hit, because I don't really want to get closer to an intruder in order to handle what needs handled. So that was my accuracy drill, was 18 yards, and I scored 2 with the Kimber, the Magnum Research, the 4 1/4 inch Rock Island, and the Ruger. And that brought us our first round and a four-way tie for first. You'll notice there that with the Hunk of Rock and the Rock Island Officers, I did not manage to find the targets at all with 3 shots with either one of those. And so that was the end of our first round, and it ended in a four-way tie. The next round was accuracy drill. This was shot by Logan. And there we go. 3 points possible, and we see Logan scored all 3 with the Kimber and with the Magnum Research. He scored 2 with each of our other 4 pistols. We did make a note here. The 4 1/4 inch Rock Island came with a factory magazine with a base plate that reads KCI USA. This magazine worked well for 1 drill. And in the second attempt to load the magazine and multiple subsequent attempts to load the magazine, the magazine malfunctioned. And it basically log jammed the ammunition. It would not feed it up the magazine housing internally, and we just eliminated that magazine. BH Spring Solutions is a Metgar magazine distributor, and we happen to have some 8-round 1911 magazines handy. We replaced the factory magazine with a Metgar magazine, and we continued with that. Firearm in the competition. After the second round of testing, we have a two-way tie for first place, and that would be the Kimber and the Magnum Research pistols. Interesting, because here after 2 rounds, and we've really just, you know, we've done accuracy drills at this point, and the 2 shortest barrel handguns in the competition are tied for first, that being the 3-inch aluminum frame of the Kimber and the Magnum Research. They're almost identical guns. Interesting, they have an identical score at this point. And tied for third, the Ruger and the Rock Island 4 1/4 inch barrel, and then a 5th place tie with the Hunk of Rock and the 1911 Officers Rock Island. Next shooting drill was the multiple adversary drill, and Logan shot that one, and that's a 7-yard multiple adversary drill. There's 6 shots possible. And I want to tell you, Logan is a newer to shooting shooter, and this kind of drill work is something that he's new to as well. And he may be our shooter of the four with the least experience. And it's interesting to see how these different handguns work in the hands of someone with, you know, more experience, less experience. And we've got that, you know, from one end to the other, basically, with these four shooters. Okay, Logan's 6-shot, 7-yard multiple adversary drill. He scored 4 with the Kimber, the Magnum Research, and the Ruger. And then scored 3 with the 4.25 and 3.5-inch barrel Rock Islands. And he scored 2 with the Hunk of Rock. So after this round, we have a tie for first place still, Kimber and the Magnum Research. The Ruger stands alone now in 3rd place, 4th place the Rock Island, 4.25-inch barrel, and 5th and 6th place in the order you see them there, the 1911 Officer's Rock Island and the Hunk of Rock. All right, next was Mark's multiple adversary drill. Again, 6 points are possible, and I did score 6 with the Magnum Research, the Ruger, and the Rock Island 4.25-inch barrel. The Kimber, I scored 4. The Rock Island 3.5-inch officers, I scored 4. And the Hunk of Rock got disqualified in this round. This happened much earlier in our testing than what I would have ever really thought would happen. You remember in our previous sessions we talked about the margin that's lost, especially in the recoil spring area, and the Hunk of Rock comes with a spare recoil spring, says, you know, change every 500 rounds. We got 14 before we had a fail to go into battery. I had a fail to go into battery twice with this 6-round drill. Having to shoot as slow as that was, you know, and push the slide into battery twice. I actually did land all 6 shots after a fashion, after we helped the gun load itself. The Hunk of Rock got disqualified in this round for failing to go into battery twice. And after looking at the scores and the cumulative score on the Rock Island Officer's model, we decided to go ahead and remove it from the competition as well. And the primary reason was for underperformance mainly attributable, I think, to the sights, primarily. Most shooters, you know, were not accessing those nearly as quickly, the little military sights nearly as quickly as the others. So for reasons of not being competitive, the 1911 Officer's model was removed after this round. So after that, that would have been the 4th round of shooting. The Magnum Research stands alone in 1st place. Ruger has moved up to 2nd place. There's a two-way tie for 3rd place with the Kimber and the Rock Island 4.25-inch barrel. And removed from the competition is the 2 shortest barrel Rock Islands. I do want to say one thing here about this, about these scores, and I'm going to admit to something that didn't cause confusion. It actually caused me some confirmation. I really thought that I would land 6 with the Kimber, just like had gone down with the Magnum Research, the Ruger, and the Rock Island 4.25-inch barrel. I was thinking this because I'm pretty decent at that drill, that drill and the targets that we're using is really not setting the bar, you know, out of reach for any of the shooters. And I went back and I shot that drill a 2nd time, just kind of off the record, not to score it, but just because I wanted to I felt like I personally had underperformed the pistol. And I went back and shot that drill again, and I landed 4 again. And I thought, well, you know, you do it 2 times in a row, that must apparently be real. And, you know, I was feeling a little bad about myself and feeling like I didn't do the Kimber justice. Apparently, apparently, I did in that particular drill. So that's how things wound up there. Our shipping lead, my wife, was the next shooter that was involved with all the pistols, and she did the 7-yard accuracy drill. And I could have had these two right here switched, but we were going by the cumulative scores. She scored 3 out of possible 3 with the Ruger. She scored 3 also with the 4.25-inch Rock Island. She scored 2 with the Magnum Research on this drill, and she scored 1 with the Kimber. She likewise was surprised by her performance with the Kimber and only landing 1 shot on that drill. That's what she shot. Not terribly surprising here. You get a little bit better sight picture, I guess, you know, and accuracy out of a 4.25-inch barrel as opposed to a 3-inch barrel handgun. But this again was kind of where we started seeing the Kimber at times it's just not performing. And I'm going to tell you, we're going to see in some of the other notes, the Kimber was very stiffly sprung, which is kind of shocking in and of itself, because Kimber also had the shortest outer recoil spring of the three with the two spring assemblies, but it is a stout spring. And the gun was almost short cycling multiple times. I took them off the forehead, off the cheek. Plamena did too. And this was a real distraction. When you've got empty brass that's, you know, crawling up your arm and you know, landing off the top of your head, side of your head, forehead, that is a real distraction when you're trying to shoot. I'm going to be the first to say that probably had an impact on my shooting with that handgun. I know it did. I know it did for Plamena. It was quite a distraction. She doesn't like that stuff flying at, flying at her head. So the next drill was Plamena's multiple adversary drill. And of course, again, that's 1 in the right target, 3 in the left, 2 back in the right. Possible 6 points on this drill. And Plamena scored 5 with the Magnum Research and with the Ruger. And she scored 4 on that drill with the Kimber. With the Rock Island, she scored only 1 with that sight acquisition. Was a challenge for her with the Rock Island 4.25-inch barrel. It really was a downfall on that drill for her. So after what would be the 6th round of shooting, we wound up in a tie for first place. The Ruger and the Magnum Research pistols tied for first. The Kimber in 3rd place, and the Rock Island 4.25-inch barrel in 4th. And Dave was our last shooter. Dave is our lead tech in the BH Custom Shop Service Department, and he gets to shoot a lot these days. He's also a 21-year Army veteran, and he's had a trip or two around the block shooting firearms, you know, certainly before his gig here with BH Spring Solutions. But Dave was perfect on the 7-yard accuracy drill with all 4 pistols. We had no real change going on with that, and we still had. Now, I hope you can appreciate this, how interesting this is. All of these are functional pistols. They've had no malfunctions per se, all 4 of them. With the exception of the function issues of the empty brass coming back towards the face with the Kimber, no real malfunctions. You know, all frankly, you know, really decent pistols. This is through 7 rounds, and we are dead tied for first with the Ruger and the Magnum Research. The Kimber is at this point off the pace, and so is the Rock Island. The Kimber's about 4 points total through 7 rounds off the pace. And you know, this the Kimber and the Rock Island, you know, they didn't necessarily do anything terribly. They just lost ground for lack of consistency, mainly, you know, cumulatively as the competition went on. And the very last round, Dave's 7-yard multiple adversary drill, and 6 points possible. And Dave was perfect with the Ruger, and he was perfect with the Kimber. He had one miss with the Magnum Research, 2 misses with the Rock Island 4 1/4-inch barrel. And, you know, after 4 shooters, 8 rounds of shooting, and you start to see these trends, you start to see the same kind of thing happening, you know, over and over. I will say this, a few days had passed since we had done our shooting. When Dave shot the Kimber, I had locked that slide back for a few days to see if we could get that recoil spring to just give a little bit of its enthusiasm up, you know, so we could get some decent slide cycling. I think we were getting better slide cycling when Dave was shooting. He scored perfect with the Kimber and the Ruger, 5 with the Magnum Research, and 2 off of perfect with the Rock Island 4 1/4-inch barrel. And after our initial testing, we have a leader, or in this case, a winner. That would be the Ruger SR 1911 Officer's Model, 2nd place, the Magnum Research. And again, you know, you think about how close this is. 4 shooters, 8 different rounds of shooting, and only 1 point separates the Ruger and the Magnum Research pistols. And, you know, probably on any given day, these two can tie. On any given day, maybe the Magnum Research, you know, maybe is a little bit better, but... I have to say, the Ruger performed nicely, nicely for everybody. And I want you to take a look at this as we go down. We're going to take a look at a review of all the shooters' scores, particularly the Ruger and the Magnum Research. Let's see how these particular pistols did for all the different shooters. Yours truly, after those 2 rounds, out of a possible 9 points, I had 8 points for the Magnum Research, the Ruger, and the 4 1/4-inch Rock Island. And the Kimber was 2 off the pace at that point. Logan shot a little better with the Kimber than I did. After 2 rounds, this is Logan's round. The Magnum Research and the Kimber, the Ruger was 1 off the pace. So again, we see the Magnum Research and we see the Ruger right up there for Logan, the second shooter. And then Plamena and Dave. Plamena, the Ruger. She scored more points with it than any of the other handguns, 1 more than the Magnum Research. But again, you know, we're just right there. And the Kimber, she was 3 off the pace with that, and 4 off the pace with the Ruger pace with the Rock Island 4 1/4. And then Dave's, he scored a perfect 9 with the Ruger and with the Kimber, and an 8 with the Magnum Research, and the 7 with the Rock Island. So these final tallies have some real consistency behind them, but wow, what a close competition that was. And I want to review some other notes that we made about the different handguns, and particularly comments from our shooters and some observations that I had. The Ruger extraction is consistent and indicates that slide velocity remains acceptable. Forward inertia of the slide when chambering around from the slide locked back position seems slightly erratic. Suspected sign that the recoil springs may be nearing a need for a change. Most controlled recoil and handling of all competing pistols as described by shooters. No real issues, no real problems here. This handgun is somewhere between 300 and 400 rounds with the original recoil springs in it, which is kind of cool. The Ruger came in first, and we're running on, you know, several hundred rounds on the recoil springs at this point. And the recoil springs, they are shorter than brand new springs, but they're not starting to worry us yet at this point. That's my personal handgun, and I have to tell you, we'll be practicing a a sooner than every 1,000 rounds spring change out in there, just because we know those springs are under high stress. But they're handling it with grace. It's a nice shooting handgun. First time my wife shot the Ruger 1911 Officer's model, she thought she was shooting a 9mm. They really are. That recoil system combined with the bull barrel, Ruger did some good work on this. And that handgun is real different than any other ones that we have in the competition. The Magnum Research, to this point, this handgun has done everything well for all shooters. There are momentary instances of extraction inconsistency and instances where ejection is anemic and the next round ejected is near excessive in terms of extraction distance. And the Magnum Research is 0.6 inch shorter than the Ruger. And even with the 3-inch barrel, it definitely gave the Ruger a run for its money, as you saw just every round. What we're talking about there with that, you know, erratic inconsistency of ejection distance, when a spring is, our experience is when a spring is really overworked, if you will, and hopefully you understand by the information we've provided before, everything in this competition, the springs are overworked. Maybe to the lesser extent, the 4.25-inch Rock Island. But we're still talking, you know, 1,000 to 2,000 rounds range for a spring change out in that handgun. And it's only one spring. You don't have to replace an assembly, and that's all, you know, pretty good. But the shorter the barrel gets, the more the margin has left the picture, and the springs are asked to do much more. When springs are asked to do more than what they probably are capable of doing, they start to have really erratic behavior. Like, you know, you're shooting along and you have an empty shell case that sails 14 feet, and then the next one barely lops out of the pistol. And that's a spring wanting to get itself out of the predicament that it's in, because it's just not handling the abuse very well. We saw some of that with the Magnum Research. Nothing catastrophic. However, definitely not the consistency of control of the slide velocity like with the Ruger and that 3-recoil spring system. It outperformed any of the other 3 or 3-something-inch barrel handguns as far as really a solid control of the slide and the slide velocity. The Kimber, showing signs that the recoil spring equation of this pistol starts out with the stiffest equation possible. Nothing consistent about the extraction from this pistol so far. Many extracted empty shell casings have ejected straight back at the shooter's faces, heads, caused by insufficient slide velocity to properly eject the empties. It is highly likely that this will change soon as the recoil springs get a little tired. It is a certainty that the frequency of empties deflecting off the faces of the shooters were a distraction, likely resulted in lower effectiveness of hits scored in the competition so far compared to the Ruger and the Magnum Research pistols. The same analysis about the behavior of the recoil springs and the recoil systems written about the Magnum Research 1911 applies here to the Kimber, but slightly more exaggerated in the Kimber. Okay, we had 1 4.25-inch barrel. It was this Rock TAC. It was a tactical version of Rock Island's Commander pistol. We wrote, due to the barrel length, this pistol should have a significant advantage over all the other competitors, but that's not what the scores reflect. Extraction has been consistent, like a handgun with more margin than its competitors should perform, but in this competition, the performance in terms of extraction is just as good as the Ruger, not better, at the 3.6-inch barrel. Shooters so far are not benefiting from the OEM sights on this pistol. Even though the front sight is a fiber optic, it's not benefiting the shooters. The 2 white dot rear sight and red fiber optic front sight creates a sight picture not excellent for fast sight acquisition. Except that the rear sights are very easy to find and the front sight is hard to find by any comparison. Currently being outperformed by 2 3-inch barrel pistols and the 3.6-inch Ruger. The KCI magazine, we have some written up about that. That really could have been used as a justification for elimination of the handgun from this competition. We decided not to do that. Mainly we wanted to keep it going in the competition, and we didn't want it to have it eliminated because the manufacturer made a poor choice in magazines. And that choice of magazine is it's too bad because that the magazine that came with the pistol, it's just not a serviceable magazine. With the replacement magazine, everything went fine. To this point, it appears the add back of barrel length to the 4 1/4-inch length is the amount of margin add back required to keep a Rock Island 1911 in this competition, apparently. And then finally, we had some information about the eliminated pistols, the 3.5 and 3.1-inch hunk of rock. And that is our completion. The next thing we're going to be doing with these handguns is we're now going to go back. We're going to take a look at the performance of the handguns, and we're going to see where we may be able to get some improved performance out of all of them. Frankly, I think they all have room for improvement. There are some ways to do that, and we're going to see if we're able to be successful, and on how many of these we're able to be successful and improve these handguns, improve the performance, and the functionality and the accuracy. Folks, we thank you for watching The Science of the 45 ACP in the Short Barreled 1911 and the BH Spring Solutions Short Barreled 1911 Six-Way Shootout. I'm Mark Allen for BH Spring Solutions, LLC, and bhspringsolutions.com.